Thank you for inviting me to take part in the meeting, because exactly it was one of the crucial decisions in Poland concerning elections in the very difficult time. And I can say that the Polish society was very strongly divided as concern the decision to make elections in time of pandemia, because exactly it was the constitutional solution that the election should be held in May, because the election should be organized. The period of the acting president. The president Duda ended his mandate on 6th of August. So for that reason, the election should be taken in May. But you know, we have in our constitution a clear solution concerning the state of emergency. And there is a clearly regulated that we have a special state of emergency, which could be announced because of natural disaster. And it was the situation of natural disaster. So many specialists in constitutional law, many activists, even ombudsman, commissioner on human rights, they ask the government to organize, to declare the state of emergency. And then the situation would be clear, because in the constitution there's a very clear rule. The election should not be organized in the time of state of emergency and 90 years after the date of the end of state of emergency. So it is a very clear solution, because of our history when you had a problem with state of emergency in the 80s. Now we have a very good solution to the constitution. But the government decided, the government had, as usual, two options. Constitutional option, or second one, purely political one. Constitutional option was exactly based on the state of emergency, and then to make, how to say, the roadmap, how to prepare the future election, even taking into account the new technologies. And then the second solution was to adopt the purely political solution and organize elections in a pandemic situation without sufficient weapons important for making elections. Because in our electoral law, we have only provisions concerning the normal classic voting, no electronic voting, no possibility to make electronic voting, and then only partially by partially using the postal voting. So we were completely unprepared for making election in the time of pandemia and in the time of lockdown, and as president rightly said, shutdown. Yes, how we can organize the electoral campaign when everything was, how to say, prohibited. The public space was prohibited. The public meetings were prohibited. And the gathering were prohibited. So there was no possibility to organize electoral campaign in a normal way. The only weapon was social media. And social media was exactly used in very active way. But it was not the best solution for making elections, because everybody said that the electoral campaign was not the just electoral campaign. And then we have exactly, taking into account this situation, the purely political situation, when the government rejected the constitutional solution, then the government looked for, I don't know how to say, for making the elections in a very, very critical situation. First of all, decided to organize election on 10th of May. 10th of May, but 10th of May, it was just a peak of a pandemia and nobody was prepared. And 6th of April, Polish parliament adopted in very quick way, on one day, new law, electoral law, amendment to electoral law, when introduced the postal voting, only postal voting. But you know, it was April, 6th April, election should be held on 10th of May. a new law was adopted months before the election, and no technical know-how to say technical solution will be were prepared for making the postal voting, because when everything is closed, postal offices are closed, how the situation should be organized? Who will make the card for voting? Who will distribute the card? How the card will be, how to say, distributed between people, voters? So it was a very exactly strong discussion and very strange, because we have candidates. The candidates tried to make an electoral campaign in month April, and the date of election on 10 May were decided, yes? But in the meantime, it was such a political atmosphere, social atmosphere, that it is impossible to have elections on 10 of May. And what then happens? One of candidates from the opposition party declared that she will not take part in this campaign because it is not a just electoral campaign. But finally, till the end, she was in the game, but everybody was a little astonished. What this means, yes, she is still candidate or not a candidate. And then it was clearly said by the Electoral Commission that Electoral Commission is not able to prepare all the documentations, et cetera, for 10 of May. And finally, we have such a situation that the election on 10 of May were, ordered, but not organized. And 10 of May, voting points were closed, and nobody came, nobody organized the election of 10 of May. And then the government looked for the new term till the end of May to organize the election, but it was completely impossible. So for that reason, they tried to make a political agreement between political parties and to find a new date for election. But in opinions of many constitution lawyers, it was out of the constitution, out of the provision of the constitution to organize elections in June. But finally, the political parties agreed and decided to make election on 28th of June and the second term of 12th of July. But it is exactly very strange what the Electoral Commission declared concerning the date of 10 of May, because State Election Commission issued a resolution in which it interpreted that the lack of possibility to vote for candidates on 10 of May was tantamount to the situation of lack of candidates. So it will be up to the Speaker of the Sejm to call new elections. But it was a very strange situation, because there were 10 candidates. They tried to make electoral campaign, and finally Electoral Commission decided that they were no candidates for election. And finally, Speaker of the Sejm decided to the date of the next election on 28th June. And on 2nd June, the new law, amendment to the law, has been passed, where it has been declared, regulated, that there will be a normal election and classic election with possibility to use the postal voting. But no possibility to use electronic voting, because it was impossible to organize and to prepare solutions in such a short term for electronic voting. So for that reason, I repeat it again, that the proposals and the demand of constitutional lawyers, ombudsman, OSCE, and other institutions to declare the state of emergency could create the better situation for elaborating a new law with possibility to have an electronic voting, because otherwise it was completely impossible. Everybody should go to the normal, pool office, I can say, or maybe using post, but post was not used very, very frequently. Everybody, majority, went to the normal voting with all the security reasons, mask, etc., long queue, waiting in the long queue. And finally, the participation in such a situation was exactly very high, because it was one of the highest in our 30 years history, when the people went to the voting. But it was so because the society was so strongly divided. Was so strongly divided as concerns the making elections and also as concerns the candidates. So for that reason, the participation in the election was so high. But the result we know, yes, it was only very small difference between two candidates, but no possibility, no using of electronic voting, but only social media. And the electoral campaign mostly has been done by social media. So in this sense, social media played very, very important role, because the one of candidates, the acting president, he has been supported by the government, and he had such a, how to say, support to make a normal election. And other, no. I don't know what has happened. What has happened?
We can hear you. We can hear you, Prime Minister.
Yes, but I haven't heard because I had such a, how to say, break, very strong.
Yeah, there was a noise, but it's gone now.
Yes. Probably somebody from the second party in our divided country decided to do it. So, but I only would like to say what is the situation. And then after result of election, it was how many, I would like only to say that when the Supreme Court and Electoral Commission and then Electoral Commission declared the result of election and said that the election was valid, there were sent about 5,000 or 8,000 protests to the Supreme Court, 5,000, almost 6,000 protests to the Supreme Court. And finally, the Supreme Court considered only 93 protests to be justified, but finally said that election were valid, and then the protest had no influence for the further course of election. And this is now the situation. We have a new president since last week, but the society is still divided. But I think that all the situation gave a very good ground for deeper discussion concerning the new amendments to electoral law, especially how to organize the law with using the artificial intelligence, e-voting, and other instruments. Because young people, they prefer this kind of voting, yes, but it was no possibility, and for the moment we are not prepared to adopt such a law, because it should be done in a very just way, not in very rush procedure, but in very normal long parliamentary procedure to guarantee all the rights in electoral process. So I would like only to say it was a tad longer, but exactly it was a very, very difficult problem, and it's still for us very, very difficult problem.